Hello, this is session number 7, and in today's session we are going to discuss engineering process areas. So in previous two sessions we have discussed process management and project management related process areas, and now today we are going to discuss engineering related process areas. Now engineering process areas cover the development and maintenance activities that are shared across engineering disciplines. The engineering process areas were written using general engineering terminologies so that any technical discipline involved in the product development process, for example software engineering, mechanical engineering, they can use them for process improvement. The engineering process areas also integrate the processes associated with different engineering disciplines into a single product development process, supporting a product-oriented process improvement strategy. Now, such a strategy targets essential business objectives rather than specific technical disciplines. So now we are going to discuss the details of engineering process areas. The engineering process areas apply to the development of any product or service in the development domain, for example, software products, hardware products, services, processes. Now there are 5 engineering process areas in CMMI development. The first is product integration, PI. Second is requirements development, RD. Third is technical solution, TS. Fourth is validation, and last is verification. Now the this diagram provides a bird's eye view of the interactions among the engineering process areas. The requirements development process area identifies customer needs and translates these needs into product requirements. Now the set of product requirements is analyzed to produce a high-level conceptual solution. Now this set of requirements is then allocated to establish an initial set of product component requirements. Other requirements that help define the product are derived and allocated to product components. Now this set of product and product component requirements clearly describes the product's performance, quality attributes, design features, verification requirements, and a lot of similar things in terms the developer understands and use those specifications. Now the requirements development process process area, it supplies requirements to the technical solution process area, where the requirements are converted into product architecture, product component designs, and product components, for example by use of coding or fabrication. Now the requirements are also supplied to the product integration process area. Now this product integration process area means where the product components are combined and interfaces are verified to ensure that they meet the interface requirements supplied by the requirements development. Now the technical solution process area develops technical data packages for product components to be used by the product integration or supplier agreement management process area, SAM, which we have already discussed. Alternative solutions are examined to select the optimum design based on established criteria. Now these criteria can be significantly different across products depending on the product type, operational environment, performance requirements, support requirements, cost, delivery schedules, and a lot of other parameters are there. Now the task of selecting the final solution makes use of the specific practices in the decision analysis and resolution process area. The technical solution process area, TS, this relies on the specific practices in the verification process area to perform design verification and peer reviews during design and prior to final build of the product. Now the verification process area ensures that selected work product meet the specified requirements. So the verification process area selects work products and verification methods that will be used to verify work products against specified requirements. Verification is generally an incremental process, starting with product component verification, and usually concluding with verification of fully assembled products. Now the verification also addresses peer reviews. Now peer reviews are a proven method for removing defects at an early stage and provide valuable insight into the work products and products components which are being developed and maintained. Now the validation process area incrementally validates product against the customer's needs. Validation can be performed in the operational environment or in a simulated operational environment. Coordination with the customer on validation requirements is an important element of this overall process area. The scope of validation process area includes validation of products, product components, selected intermediate work products, and processes. These validated elements can often require re-verification and revalidation. Issues discovered during validation are usually resolved in the requirements development or technical solution process area. The product integration process area contains the specific practices associated with generating an integration strategy, integrating product components, and delivering the product to the customer. The product integration uses the specific practices of both verification and validation in implementing the product integration process. Verification practices verify the interfaces and interface requirements of the product components prior to the product integration. Now, the interface verification is an essential event in the integration process. During product integration in the operational environment, the specific practices of the validation process area has to be used. Now, most process standards agree that there are two ways that processes can be applied. And these two ways are called as recursion and iteration. Now, recursion occurs when a process is applied to successive levels of system elements within a system structure. So the outcomes of one application are used as inputs to the next level in the system structure. For example, the verification process is designed to apply the entire assembled product, the major product components, and even components of the components. So how far into the product you apply the verification process depends entirely on the size and the complexity of the end product. So that is how recursion occurs. Now, iteration occurs when processes are repeated at the same system level. That is why it is called as iteration. New information is created by implementation of one process that feeds the information back into the same process or related process. Now, this new information typically raises questions that must be resolved before completing the processes. For example, iterations will most likely occur between requirements development and technical solutions. So reapplication of the processes can resolve the questions that are raised during technical solution, and we can again go back to the requirement development process. Iterations can ensure quality prior to applying the next process. So these are the two important methods in which processes can be applied: recursion and iteration. So this is end of session number 7. We have discussed engineering process areas in this session, which are product integration, requirements development, technical solution, validation, and verification. And also we have discussed the methods in which these processes can be applied, that is the method of recursion and method of iteration.